It's the National Football League on EA Sports. And we'll see Michael Thomas. He's been a quarterback's best friend, nearing 1,300 yards receiving on the year. It's the Saints and the Eagles coming up next. It's the NFL EA Sports as you talk about at Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia, PA. Today, we've got a good NFC matchup on tap between the New Orleans Saints. Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon, and Charles, you take a look at the Eagles, and they know that they are in for a fight here.
And anytime you're dealing with the number one defense in the league, all through your preparation, you know that yards are going to be tough to come by. But working in their favor, they can run the football, one of the top five teams in the league in that category. So I expect this one to be a tight, hard-hitting affair, and both teams playing to their strengths.
Jake Elliott ready to get this one started. And off we go from Lincoln Financial Field. Taking in at the three. Oh, a good return up past the 30. He's at the 50. The 30. And a terrific return as they finally do stop him, but not before he's inside the 15.
There hasn't been a game played where defenses don't talk about coming out on their toes and being the aggressor. But boy, if you give up a return like that, you're really starting it on your heels. Let's see how they adjust.
So here are the Saints now with great starting field position. Bringing them out in his eighth year out of Florida State, the former Heisman Trophy winner, Jameis Winston.
And there was a positive in last week's loss. No interceptions thrown by him. But he only threw one touchdown pass, and you know he wants that to improve. He might even consider that as part of the reason that they couldn't take the win last time out. I believe we'll see a more aggressive version of him this week whenever they're nearing the end zone.
That's cool. It's so close. He gets it to the one. Out of bounds right there. 13 yards on the game's opening play.
How about the way they're moving the ball down the field? They had a big play a moment ago. Followed up with another nice one here. And before you know it, they're already looking at first and goal.
Kamara diving for the end zone, and he is in. Touchdown. So a good job there, Charles, taking advantage of the short field, and they score first, punching it in on the short touchdown run.
I love the theme there, right? They didn't have to do anything big on that drive. Took advantage of where they were on the field, took it downfield, put the ball in the end zone. The only thing big on that drive, the six on the scoreboard.
Will Lutz on for the point after. He hasn't missed an extra point all season, and he won't miss this one either. And it's 7-0. They had the short field, and they made quick work of it. Just two plays to get into the end zone. After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. Now this is going to be returned from the back line of the end zone. And he'll be dropped at the 21-yard line. So bringing it out of the end zone proves not a good decision. Loses him about 4 yards. Philly's offense getting ready, and Jalen Hurts ready to lead them. The second-round pick who started his career at Alabama then finished with an electric senior season at Oklahoma.
And I'll bet he's talking to his guys about resisting the temptation to try and turn this into an up-and-down game, almost like basketball, where both teams press and one team gets an advantage. Our team's trying to run with them, and they're just not equipped for it. Doesn't matter whether you're equipped or not. Just settle in. Get calm before you go for the big strikes.
And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe 3. The numbers for him from a week ago. A boatload of carries, 124 yards.
One thing I do know, teams in the NFL don't treat this like a pitcher throwing a no-hitter. It's been mentioned all week long about going out and getting him the rushing title. He'll see the ball and he'll see it often.
And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. Hurts finally got it there. First down, Philadelphia. Sets up to throw it. He's got his target. That's Zach Pascal. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40. Second down at 6 now from the 42. The Eagles have 14-1 now on the year. They've certainly found their groove of late. Winners of 5 in a row.
And this team is absolutely playing their best football right now. This is the best that we've seen them play in a long time, partner. Sky's the limit as far as they're concerned. Their confidence, real.
Oh, and Hurts is going to be hit and taken down to the ground. Marcus Davenport in there to drop him for his 11th sack of the year. Here's Aaron Sipos out now to punt on fourth down. Deontay Hardy back deep. The call for a fair catch, and it's made at about the 23-yard line. 36 yards on the punt with no return, and the Saints will take over with a first down and 10. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And Charles, you look at these two teams, and these are those kind of litmus test games in the second half of the season that if you're a coach or a player, you can either really look forward to them or really dread them, depending on your point of view.
And if you're dreading them, you're not going to go very far in the playoffs. You need to look forward to these kind of games, because here we've got two division leaders, but real contenders for the NFC title. But you need some games just to toughen you up a bit and ensure that you're ready for the shot of playoff football.
Winston. And this is going to be in.
It's going to be the only time they'll try and hit that route to the outside in this game. He'll test the perimeter, but that time, they were up to the challenge.
That's taken on the 25. Nice punt, but good work on the return to get back 11 yards. And the Eagles will have it, taking over first and 10. Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. But first down, Hurts. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. From the 39, Hurts. He's got down. He's got it. His tight end over the middle. And he'll be tackled on the other side of midfield at the 46-yard line.
I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere. They want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well. And that's what they just did on that play.
He delivers another to Goddard. Complete. And not much happening there. He's taken down.
A foul.
A late penalty flag in the backfield. This looks like a roughing call. So roughing the passer penalty, never one that you like to see.
Not at all, and especially when in that final push of the season. You can't afford to get your quarterback hurt before the playoffs roll around. And we know they'll be here before you know it.
And he fights forward for a modest 2-yard gain, second down. The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. Throwing from the gun, it's Hurts. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. From the gun, it's Hurts. And he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Cameron Jordan, he's the one that got home and takes him down for a loss of 9. Second down and goal. Hurts. And it's incomplete. Broken up. But there is a flag down. Let's see what that's about. Yeah, we kind of sensed that one. He got a little too far forward before throwing, and that one will set them back.
And remember, at the NFL level, being aware of where the line of scrimmage is crucial.
Under pressure, and he'll go down back at the 26-yard line. Give the sack to David Onyemata, the product of Nigeria by way of Canada.
A always talk about how teams are so competitively matched and you just want to make those plays that give you an advantage. How about right here? The difference between letting them score a touchdown versus holding them to a field goal, that's absolutely huge for the play he just made.
No, he made it, taking the loss there on third down.
So he able to end that drive with 3 points in this one possession ball game.
And ideally, you want to end every drive with points. Most quarterbacks have told us end it with a kick, right? PAT, that's number one. Field goal, you'll take. Punts, you really don't want to do that. In this case, they'll take the field goal and get prepared for the rest of the game.
And they will wrangle him down a couple yards shy of the 30. Down onto the field comes New Orleans.
And as these guys enter play in Week 17, we know one thing. They are playoff bound, but they want to win that division title. They told us that is a goal that's been posted in their locker room since day one. They've got the chance to control their own destiny.
And there's nothing more powerful than saying that you won the division, because I know from building a team, when I talk with all the GMs and the player personnel directors, they always talk about to get to the playoffs in the NFL, you have to have a team that's constructed to win your division. Beat those teams first. That's your number one path to getting there, and they can get that done in this game.
Winston throw complete there to Thomas. Here's Kamara trying to run for it. He needed a yard. That's exactly what he got. Earns him a new set of downs.
Just about every coach we talk to says the crowd shouldn't affect us. That shouldn't be an issue. And then the next breath they talk about taking the crowd and taking them out of the game by picking up first downs and keeping them at bay. I think we just saw an example of that there.
It's important to do, especially early in the game like they have.
Yeah, he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. All told, it's an even 30 and a first down.
Well, for Alvin Kamara, that speed-size combo, just about exactly what you want for a running back, and he uses that size, that strength to bust through a would-be tackler there.
Yeah, this could be a sign of what this defense is in for, because you know all week long the coaches were preaching to the defense, you've got to be able to wrap up against a back like him, or he can make you pay. Technique, technique, technique.
And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage.
And you can see the distance traveled there after the initial contact and the next-gen stats.
So after the loss of a yard, they'll look to push forward here on second down and 11. They'll try to throw now. Winston. There's Chris Olave. And he's going to get this down near the 25. Here's Winston. He'll find his tight end. It's Adam Troutman. And he is going to have a Saints first down by a couple of yards as they're able to convert here on third and three. From the red zone now, Winston. And a dangerous throw there on the drop off. Incomplete. Nearly intercepted. Throw again. Winston. He gets it to Thomas. Touchdown, Saints. Michael Thomas. His fourth touchdown on the year. As his guys are able to extend their lead.
A nice connection there, finding his target, and that'll put six up on the board.
Just like they drew it up in their playbook and reiterated it on the sidelines, right? Perfect route, a good throw, and the defense, they had no answer for that right there.
Lutz to try to add the PAT. And this one's right through to make it a 14-3 ball game. A good drive that time as they go nine plays in all.
And it's Michael Thomas who ends it with a touchdown reception.
After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. And he'll put up the stop sign there as his guys will get it at the 25. Here's the Philadelphia offensive unit now as they head out to take over possession.
And last time, able to get three. It's not what they wanted. They wanted six, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drop.
They'll take it. I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker try to run the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for six. A good gain on first. Has him set up with second and just a couple of inches now from the 29. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. Now a timeout called for by the offense. So as they take it over, we step aside. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
Right back to Sanders on first down. And he's going to be brought down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. After one, a 14-3 ball game. Now second quarter action from Philadelphia, and it's the Eagles in possession. The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine. It's a second down run with Sanders. And he still has yet to get on track in this first half as they're going to stop him behind the line. They wind up losing a couple there, so they go behind the original line of scrimmage. And now third and 11 coming up.
The running lanes have definitely not been there for him here in the first half, and I don't think it's all been his fault. His offensive line hasn't given him much space. A loss results there.
They'll get this one complete. That's A.J. Brown. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle's made at the Saints 42. That's a third down conversion to 24 yards there. Nice play.
Yeah, these are the types of plays they're going to need to hit on if they're going to get back into this game. It hasn't been the greatest of first halves, but this is a nice throw here on third down, and they keep the drive going.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Here's Hurts to throw. Oh, you saw that one coming. It's intercepted. Thrown back across his body. Picked off by Marshon Lattimore. And the Saints will take over here as they get it up to the 43-yard line. The Saints offense on the field ready to get their drive started. They'll start in excellent field position following the INT. Nice little juke. And they'll get this down to the 42-yard line.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open. Just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space. And it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. To throw is Winston. And he's got the hook up to Landry. And they're going to get this down near the 35-yard line. The Saints on third down. They've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. This is third and 4. Jameis to throw it. Got an open man. It's Olave. And he has another first down as they'll get the ball down to the Eagles 21. 15 yards there on the catch and run.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
First down, Winston. To the right side, and he's got Landry complete. And he is out of bounds right around the 10-yard line. 11 more on that one, and another first down. That catch, number 750 of his NFL career, and it puts him even with not just one, but two Hall of Famers, Michael Irvin and Charlie Joyner. So some pretty good company at 750.
Now you're talking about the playmaker, Michael Irvin, and the guy who...
And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by the safety, Jarquiski Tart. And the Eagles are going to take possession here at their own 6-yard line. So the ball changing hands on the interception. But meanwhile here, we do have an injury on the play. And not what you want to see this late in the season. Medical staff is going to check on him. And we'll step aside for a moment. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Sanders. Calling a gain of 6 on the play. And it'll be second down. Hurts a handoff to Sanders. just shy of the 30. And now a pause because we got A.J. Brown dinged up on that last play, and they're going to have to get some medical attention to him. We're always unfortunate to see an injury, especially this close to the end of the regular season. We'll step aside. They'll throw on first down with Hurts. He's going to loft one deep left side here. He's got a man complete. And they're going to get this down to about the 17-yard line here.
I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play that picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
A real field flipper there as all of a sudden they've got a first down in the red zone. Hurts. So nothing doing there, and that'll make it second down. Throwing is Hurts. On right side, caught by Goddard, the tight end. They get six. That'll leave them with third and four. In search of 4 yards here to pick up the first down. Out of the gun now on third down. And Haskell's got it. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. And a gain of 7, and it gets him a new set of downs. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. And he will push his way forward down about the 3-yard line. So the ball position now at the 3. Here's second and goal. Sanders. It's into the end zone for the touchdown. He finishes off the drive with a touchdown run, Charles. Remember, he also had a catch on this drive as well.
And that's what running backs want to be in today's NFL. A complete back, three downs, stay on the field, run it, and catch it. And he gets it done.
Elliott good on the extra point. And that makes it a 14-10 ball game. So that drive goes 8 plays, and it was Miles Sanders who finished it off for the touchdown run. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback.
Well, we're probably not the first, but all of us at EA Sports certainly want to wish you and yours a happy and prosperous new year. And as a celebration of that, a big slate of NFL games on this Sunday, week 17. Second to last weekend of the NFL docket. Later tonight, the battle for Los Angeles, Rams and Chargers, 5:15 Pacific at SoFi. And then on Monday night, Charles and I are part of the Cincinnati. Bills and Bengals, two cold weather teams, and that will be a frigid Paul Brown Stadium.
Play fake, Winston. Pressure comes, and down he goes. So 7 yards from the first down here as they come up to the line of scrimmage. On third down, Winston being chased out left. Throw across his body and it's intercepted. Darius Slay with a pick. And he takes this one back in the end zone. Eagles defense puts up a 16-8.
Trying to take on a Pro Bowl cornerback, and what a play to make the interception and also bring it back for six.
And he is so good that we've seen teams absolutely stay away from throwing the ball at him. Here he's just reading the quarterback's eyes the entire way, makes a great play on the football, and turns it into six.
Elliott now to have the extra point. It's good, and they'll take a 17-14 lead. A heck of a play there defensively, getting the interception, navigating his way into the end zone for the touchdown. So they throw to pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback.
The New Orleans offense set to take over.
And they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really comes into play. How's the head coach handling it? The offensive coordinator? Sometimes they just make a joke. All right, guys, had your fun?
All right, throw it up in the air.
Let's get back on track here. Sometimes that'll work just fine.
I guess it's time now to lean on that leadership. Give him 10 yards there, and about by the nose of the football, he's going to have a first down.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. Now a first down carry. It's Kamara. Takes it to about the 37.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
Second and eight. Working out of the gun, Winston. And Jameis intercepted a third time. Darius Slade. Like this from him, and I think he's in line, we've discussed it before, for NFL Defensive Player of the Year.
And a big reason why, I think, is because
he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Marcus May with a pick. Pass the 20. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. In a tight game like this, that could be an incredibly important pick six, CD. And remember, it cancels out the one that the opposition had earlier in this ball game.
You're right about that, partner, because each side came up with plays to swing the momentum their way. Still plenty of time left for either team to come through with a win, though. Can someone else make a similar play and win it for their club?
Alonso looked at the extra ball. It's up and good to make it 21-17. So the defense creating some points, not only getting the interception, but then returning it to the end zone for the pick six. Takes it at the 7. And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27. In the process of that kick return, it appears we had an injury. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. Hurts now, hoping to make up for that pick six. And on the catch right side, this is Sanders. Give him a gain of 5 on the completion. And it's second down. Hurts sets up to throw it. He'll hit Watkins on the crossing route. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. It'll be a gain of 16 for number 16. One first down, Hurts. A good throw here, finding Pascal. And they're going to get this to about the 44-yard line. From the 44, Hurts. Now they go screen. It's complete. They find some open field. They get the numbers. There he goes. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Miles Sanders as the first half is winding down. Have taken the lead here in the final stages of this first half.
Boy, Charles, this offense is just so explosive. They lead the league in scoring, and another example of just how good they are right there on that play.
Yeah, we often overstate about how explosive teams are, but this team is truly a threat to score every snap, especially on the first few plays of any series. And a big strike like that, that only adds to their reputation as the league's best offense.
Elliott good with a PAT, and that gives him a 3-point lead. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out.
Nothing but green grass here, no field. And finally, he's taken down at the 18. And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call. The kick by Lutz is good, and that will do it for this first half. So we've come upon halftime here in Week 17 as we get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report. Coach!
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. Happy New Year, everybody. Welcome into our EA Sports Halftime Report. It's a busy Week 17 of the regular season, so let's get right to it. We begin on this New Year's Day up in the Big Apple. Last night, they got to see the ball drop in Times Square. Today, they get Indianapolis taking on the New York Giants. And it's the Colts who have the lead in that one. Kiki Cutie, a touchdown reception. From there, we move to H-Town to check on the Texans at home at NRG Stadium. And they've got the lead in that ball game over the visiting Jaguars. 3 touchdown passes there for Davis Mills. Lastly, let's check on one final game for you. And they've gone to the half in that ball game with the visiting Browns out on top. Amari Cooper, 2 touchdown catches in that first half alone. On now to a look at the next-gen stats in that first half for the Saints. And in a tie ball game, they've got to be asking themselves, what can we do to get this passing game on track for the second half to come? Meanwhile, for the Eagles, they were even better throwing the football. Lots of open receivers to choose from, and you can bet that'll continue to be a focus in the second half. With both of these offenses having their way, it's not likely they'll need to be doing a whole lot at halftime. But the defenses are definitely in need of some adjusting. And for the call of the second half, let's go back out to Brandon and Charles.
Yeah, Coach, certainly no shortage of action in those first 2 quarters. Definitely got to work on my touchdown calls, so we'll see how much voice I have left for the second half here. The Eagles ready to go on offense to begin this third quarter. This offense ready for the first drive of the third quarter. Well, quarters number 1 and 2, entertaining. We saw some good offense points put up, Charles, and all tied on the scoreboard.
And it sets us up for what could be a really fun second half, because we've seen both sides score almost at will here in the first half. And now, here in the second half, getting the ball first, you've got to think, hey, we can go out and really run our offense the way we did in the first half. But not a defensive player. Thinking is, can I make a play to really help out my team and break this streak of offense?
And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there. Now we'll get a stoppage here for an injured player, and it appears to be Devontae Smith who's having some problems here. And not what you want to see this late in the season. Medical staff is going to check on him, and we'll step aside for a moment. And for the Saints here on third down, an extra defensive back on the field. Looking to throw. Wide open is Watkins. He's got it. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark it down at the 49.
Holding. Offense.
He's trying to protect his quarterback's blind side. Got nabbed for the hole.
Yeah, one job over there. Make sure that man does not get hit. So if you have to hold occasionally, do so, because they don't catch all of them. This time they did.
He'll fire it deep for Rager. And Hurts is intercepted, his 3rd of the game. Picked off by Marshawn Lattimore. And the Saints are going to have the short field here as they'll take over right at the 50. First possession of the third quarter, an interception, so maybe a second half tone setter.
Indeed, and not the tone they wanted to set. That's the equivalent of running out the wrong door and running into your pool instead of running out onto the field. A real dud for that one.
Has that happened to you before?
No, but I've heard stories about teams actually doing that back in the good old days.
Now the attention turns to the Saints offense getting ready for their first possession of the second half. They'll have good field position at midfield following the turnover as they start with a first down here. Winston to give. It's Kamara. And good penetration here. They'll get this down only to about the 49-yard line. second and nine, just a yard on that last run. Now Winston. And this one is incomplete. He says it crossed out of bounds at about the 17-yard line.
Hurts and the Eagles come up here first and 10
at their own 17-yard line. They'll try and start this drive in the air. They'll wind up getting 7 on the play, and it's second down.
Nice rhythm throw there on first down. He located his tight end, made a nice easy pitch and catch.
Hoping he can break a tackle or two. Wasn't able to do that there, but still good yardage.
Hurts throw here taken in as he's able to find Goddard. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 83 yards receiving now for him in the afternoon as he's got a first down here.
They'll run with Sanders up the middle and give him about 5 as he gets this up to the 48-yard line. After the pickup of 5, here's second and 5. They'll go again with Sanders. And he's going to take this across the 50 and into Saints territory. Calling a gain of 4 there, so it sets up a big play here. 3rd and a yard. So they just need 1 yard here to pick up the first down. They'll fake the give to Sanders, and now Hurts.
But that's complete to Sanders. And he's going to have an Eagles first down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion.
Certainly had success throughout this contest getting him the ball in the passing game, and there he picks up another first down. Whatever they saw going into this one, they've been able to capitalize on it, and no adjustment has been made to take it away.
Play action. Here's Hurts.
Middle of the field. He finds Pascal. And he'll be brought down at about the 23-yard line. With that grab, he now sits at 200 for his career, and maybe more importantly, a first down.
Here's Hurts to throw. And swung out wide to Sanders. And he's brought down inside the 20 at the 18-yard line.
Here comes Sanders on the toss right. And he's going to be stopped well behind the line of scrimmage. And that's pretty much going to wipe out their gain from first down. That's going to go down as a loss of 5. And it brings up 3rd down.
I think it's pretty evident. We can say what a difference a week makes. Last week, he ran pretty much wild, didn't he? Did pretty much what he wanted to do. But this one, they stopped him cold. That, to me, that's good scouting. And even better execution.
Yeah, and they stopped him behind the line right there. They obviously watched the tape a few times and made some adjustments.
Called in over the middle by Rager. And he is stopped just short on 3rd down. Got 9 yards, but needed 10.
A short game that doesn't get him the first down brings up a 4th down situation.
Really nice job defensively. They knew where the sticks were. They got the stop before it.
So Hurts is off, and on comes Jake Elliott for the Eagle field goal.
This a 31-yard attempt. The kick by Elliott is good, and they have regained the lead.
So given 3 on that drive, you know, normally you'd say we'll take it, but they're constantly flying around. It feels like a little bit of a letdown.
Yeah, you just have to wonder. Field goal is going to be enough, because as you pointed out, the way touchdowns have been scored, does kicking a field goal actually put you at a disadvantage the rest of the way?
Taken in at the 3. And no alley to be found. The coverage was solid, and he's dropped at the 18.
The Saints coming out now to take the field.
And Charles, a very uninspired effort. The last time we saw them out there was a quick 3 and out, then they punted the football.
Yeah, and you never want to get has stopped so soundly during this series, but what would be even worse now is letting it happen again right here. They've got to get going.
Eagle pressure, too much this time. Yes. Buried by multiple defenders on the drive's first play. But the number one mission of any offensive line, you got to protect that quarterback, keep him safe back there. This time, the rush got to him in a hurry. To try again after the sack. Winston. That's going to be complete on the sideline, but, you know, that's all left out. Titans pass go ahead here, needing a full 15 yards to move the chains. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And that will be incomplete.
It's almost a surprise to see an incomplete pass on third down, isn't it?
And they have had their foot on the gas all game long, but here finally stalling out. On fourth down, the punt team is on as this is sent away. Take it from just outside the 30. 13 yards, the tally on the return there. And it will be Eagles football, first and 10. Philadelphia getting set to take the field. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. When you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're not too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is too bad.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them, not easily.
As they began this draft, they were going to attack since they're part of the league. Would they continue to try and push the ball downfield? Well, after one play, it appears that the answer is yes.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Hurts going to keep it running right. And the follows blockers there all the way down to the 23-yard line. Another strong gain on the last two plays. They moved it a combined 33 yards. But there is no antidote for speed, even at the quarterback position, as he keeps it himself and turns it into good yardage.
And it still takes time for a defender to react, even as quarterbacks carry the ball more and more in today's NFL. They're still a little bit in disbelief and realize, oh my goodness, he's running with the ball. He may be 8, 10, 12 yards downfield at that point.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. His pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Chauncey Gardner-Johnson with a pick. And a great return here gets this one all the way down to the 26-yard line. Charles, whatever's going on between his ears right now, it's just not completely calculated correctly. 7 picks between last week and this week after that one.
And they always say the most important part of a player is those 6 inches between the ears. But right now, it's all those interceptions that are going on. So whoever his trusted confidant is on the sidelines, I don't know if it's the offensive coordinator, the quarterback's coach, maybe the backup quarterback, that's who he needs to get with now and get himself calm.
Following the interception, Winston. To the right side, and he's got Landry complete. And he's going to be taken down right at the 10-yard line. So not quite a first and goal. It's first and 10 from the 10. Well, pounded up the middle of Kamara. And running room hard to come by here. He gets it down to the 8. The last run good for 2. Here's 2nd and 8. Winston. And this one taken in on the right sideline, but not in the field. So it's incomplete. Too far, brings up 3rd down. Winston. We'll get this one underneath to Kamara. Touchdown! Alvin Kamara. He scored on the ground and through the air. And the Saints have retaken a 3rd-quarter lead. But he is putting in a great all-around game, Charles. He already ran one in for a score, and now they utilize him in the passing game.
And they put a lot of pressure on a defensive coordinator and defense, don't they? Because they're used to him as a runner. But it turns out he's just as dangerous as some of those receivers, and he showed it right there. You don't pay enough attention to him defensively, he makes you pay.
He will return this from deep in the end zone.
and ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. This offense back out and set to go for their next drive. As this offense takes the field against CD, remember last drive, they were moving the football, but then they threw that costly interception, so we'll see if they can right the ship here on this drive.
And doesn't that just sum up football? We see it all the time, the way the defense goes from losing the battle to making a huge play and stealing the momentum. So you know they're riding up right now, and they're going to challenge this offense and our quarterback one more time.
And we'll see if the offense is up for that challenge here as things start to get more interesting here in the second half. They go play action with Hurts. And this is caught by Watkins. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. Now we go for 26 and a first down.
Well, that's a more than acceptable read right there because it's so encouraged. So timing is everything. This time he went for his man to come open, puts it right on him, and they pick up a first down.
So in Saints territory now, here's first and 10 at the 43. Running right, here's Sanders. And he'll be brought down at about the 42. Credited with a 1 yard gain there to make it second and 9.
1 yard gain brings up second and 9.
Hurts. He'll try to set up the screen, it's complete. Is the National Football League on EA Sports. And welcome back. We are in the city of brotherly love, Philadelphia. It's the Eagles behind on the scoreboard, but with the football here as we start the fourth quarter. On first and 10, it's Sanders. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5. Throwing is Hurts. This is caught. And he's brought down. Second catch for him today. And it'll wind up a first down.
And here we are in the fourth quarter. Partner, we'll watch him drive through. It will be a goal and touchdown. And you have to know, this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there. Not just for himself.
And he's in. Fly Eagles touchdown. It's a 1 yard touchdown run. And the Eagles answer back with a touchdown of their own to take a fourth quarter lead. A plenty of scoring here of late, and our lead changes hands now in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, they just gave up a touchdown the other end, so they knew that with time getting short, they had to put something together here. And they were able to do so and retake the lead right back.
Now an important extra point here to stretch this lead to a field goal. He's got it, and this is indeed up to a 3-point lead. So this drive spans 7 plays, and it was Miles Sanders who finished it off with a touchdown run. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. Carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Out comes the Saints offensive unit and the NFC playoff race. Let's have a look at it. Still a lot to be determined in terms of their final seeding. We do know they'll be in the playoffs, but in what shape, what capacity, we're not sure. But here, ready for a sports cliche, then just take them one game at a time, right?
Yeah, they have to. And look, so the thing about cliches, they've been proven over time. All right, we know that. So, yes, take it one game at a time, but make sure that there's no let-up, no getting off the gas, right? No mental letdowns, because each one is important for them.
The Saints on third down, 50%, 4 for 8. This is third and 9 to throw Winston. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
Because I just broke up another pass and took away a big shot that you were trying to succeed with.
That'll go as a punt of 34 yards that time. And they will take over first and 2. And now come the Eagles. Their defense got the stop, forced the punt, and now you really start to monitor the clock as they nurse this slim lead. The Eagles in good position to start out as they come up first and 10 at their own 43. And good vision there as he's across midfield and down to the 45-yard line. 60 yards rushing for him, now with a couple of touchdown runs to boot. They'll throw on first down with Hicks. That'll be caught, Rager with it. And he'll be brought down inside the 40-yard line. Working with his second and 4. He'll look to throw. Going across the middle, and Goddard's got it. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle's made at the Saints' 25-yard line. They give him 13 yards there on the play, a fresh set of downs. Now a carry for Sanders. They get him to the ground right on the cusp of the red zone after a pickup of 5 or 6. The first down run got 5. Here's 2nd and 5. Hurts sets up to throw it. And that one going to come up short. Low throw. Something we haven't really seen much of from him. An incomplete pass.
Yeah, last week he finished at 70%. This week he's up over 80%. I don't know how you slow him down. Pass rush is usually the best way, because a quarterback on his back usually can't complete a pass.
And he is going to have an Eagles first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. They're going to look to throw. And he's going to be dropped back at the 15-yard line. Marcus Davenport able to get in there for his 2nd sack of the afternoon.
This is a little hard for me to compute because I'm watching sack after sack happen, but somehow they're still behind in the game. I would expect all of this defensive pressure to translate to them taking a lead, and thus far, it hasn't happened. Time's winding down. They don't want to lose this type of performance from these ace pass rushers.
And the gain of 5, and that brings up 3rd and a full 10 yards.
He decided to run a hitch route. It really helped to have a guy who could turn it loose. And boy, he rifled one in there on that one. Not much run after catch, but it went through really well.
And down he goes. Pressure gets him back at the 14. They get him that time thanks to the safety blitz as he sank for a loss of 4. The kick by Elliott is good. And high fives for that one as that drive ends in 3. So they get the 3, but you wonder now, is that going to be enough?
Excellent question, because when I look at the smiles on that side of the field, it's a little tight out there. If they had scored a touchdown there, those would be big half-moon grins right now because they feel a whole lot better about their position.
And on a touchdown in the other direction, all of a sudden they're down. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Out onto the field comes New Orleans. See if they can put this drive in the end zone, Charles, because it's been a little bit of a rough go at times. They've had to punt the football a ton in this ball game because of stalled out drives.
So are you saying that you're kind of tired of seeing the punter run out there and do this thing during this game? Is that what you're trying to say?
Well, I mean, I'm okay with it. I have a feeling that this offense, they don't want to see the punter again.
And frankly, the punter doesn't want to run out there anymore himself. He'd love to see his offense put together a drive and give his leg a rest. Ready?
They'll break the huddle, come up on second and eight at the 27-yard line. Here's Winston. Dancing to his left. And this one too low.
This is a perfect example of someone who's in the world. This man, I think, with 2 inches, it's a fire in there, really too much so far. In the ground, and not only that, I put the appropriate velocity on the football.
So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves him staring up here at a third and eight. Now Winston. Absolutely, just needed a touch more air under it. Instead, he fired an absolute bullet. Here comes the Saints punter now, as he's on for the fifth time here today. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. Football, and they take possession of the football and have it at the 36-yard line.
I feel like you and I could be in our backyard with our hands right now. What did they always say when they were throwing us the ball? Look it all the way in. Make sure you secure it. That had the feeling of not happening there on that play, that he didn't have full control of the ball.
When that punt's coming in, I have a return punt, but I would imagine it's tough to monitor those guys coming full steam ahead at you.
It really is. You try and get that peak to know where they are about whether you should fair catch it or not, but sometimes you just have to have a sense, a feeling, and just have to make sure, number one, though, you catch the ball and put it away.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. They'll run out of the gun with Kamara. And he'll take this down to the 33.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. Wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had his eyes on that one being bigger.
The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six. Play action now. Winston. They'll get this out to Kamara. And he'll be marked down at about the 26-yard line.
That's a pretty play there coming out of the backfield. But as that back, you've got to be conscious of making sure you're securing the football. When you get out in open field, sometimes you get a little loose with it as you're trying to get up ahead of steam. Make sure you keep it close to your body because those defenders are trying to punch it free. He does a nice job there protecting the ball and picking up a first down. Let's go, man.
Jameis now on first down. Back to Kamara for another catch. And he's brought down here just outside of the 20.
And a broken tackle along the way, and really we shouldn't be surprised, should we? That's what runners do, especially the best of ones. They break tackles and gain extra yardage.
Meanwhile, Winston's throw caught by his receiver, Hill. First target, first catch, and a first down.
When an offense reads blitz, doesn't matter where it's coming from, tight ends know that they become a big part of the passing game because it should be an easy outlet when all those extra bodies are trying to get to the quarterback. A hot route, so to speak.
Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So it's Saints football as we get you reset. They come up on a first and 10, desperately needing a score here on what could be their final drive. Kamara up the middle. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. They come up on a first and goal and most likely 4-down territory as they need a touchdown and a PAT for the lead. Now here's a look for the end zone, but that one's going to wind up incomplete. They'll go again from the 3 here on second and goal. They'll run it with Kamara. And he'll bury his way into the end zone for a safe touchdown. Alvin Kamara, his 26th touchdown, drawing even with Marshall Faulk for the fourth most in a single season. And the Saints are an extra point away from going back on top here in the fourth. And they would not be denied on the ground, powering it in just one play after they got stopped short.
And how about how many tight ends are on the field? Because in today's NFL, we think of the tight end more as a pass catcher. But this quarter, they tell them you've got to be able to run block to stay on this team. And they committed to it and got it done right there.
Critical extra point up and good. And that is going to put them on top by a point, and it sets us up for quite a finish. After the touchdown, wants to kick it off. Takes it at the 7. Now a crease here as he's past the 30. And all in all, a pretty solid return. Nearly got it to the 35, while marking down officially at the 34. Hurts and the Eagles now down by 1. A little over a minute and a half remaining. And their 5-game winning streak hanging in the balance here.
Come on, boys. Let's count the run.
They'll look to throw. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Now a timeout here, at least for the moment. Looks like one of the Saints is injured, shaken up on that last play. Got to assume this defense will be charging again here. It's 2nd and 15. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. He's got a man complete. Now we'll get a quick timeout called by New Orleans, number 2. Yeah, they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. Up the middle they go with Sanders. And they'll get to him just inside the 15, even after that strong run we witnessed. Now the defense will burn their 3rd and final timeout as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming 2nd down play. Another run with Sanders. And he's taken down at the 7 after a gain of 7. For a lot of people, MVP award means a quarterback award usually, but over 100 yards again last week, and they're going to have to look his way more than once when giving out this award this season, I think.
Yeah, it's not just the consistency. It's been some plays that we've seen where we talk about it for weeks thereafter. That's what we're getting out of him. Over 100 yards last week. Expect to continue that in this game, too.
Sanders, and he will have the first down before he's brought down at the 3. 4 yards on the pickup, good enough to extend the drive.
I'm a little surprised right here. They've got 3 timeouts left. The clock's running down, and they aren't using them. Those timeouts do you no good at home. Use them now.
And we are set for a great finish as that timeout comes in with 2 seconds to go in this football game. Right now, everything resting on the right foot of Jake Elliott. 2 seconds on the clock, this for the win. And the kick is good. He got it. And it's official now. It's a complete blowout, but instead they needed every single one of those in this close, high-scoring affair.
Well, Brandon, I'm still on the edge of my seat after that one, because when you have that much scoring and it still comes down to one possession game at the end, that's not something we see very often. And in this case, these offenses, they brought it. The defenses, they're going to need some work going forward.
So for Philadelphia, they move to a sparkling 15-1 with 1 game still to go in the regular season.